What is up, guys? It is Christ, and we are back with another video. Welcome back to Megadeth Monday. It's going to be a little bit late. I do apologize for that, but we're going to power through nonetheless. So I didn't intend for this to happen. I just picked a couple of – well, I picked three videos for today, two of which were I just picked randomly out of them, and apparently two of them are actually from Euthanasia. So we got Blood of Heroes today. We have Elysian Fields, and then finally we have – post-American world. Pretty excited for all three. Euthanasia is a really good album, so I'm pretty excited to check out these two. I know they're going to be good songs, as well as Dystopia. I have high expectations because I've heard a few tracks off of that album, and I really like Dystopia. So that's probably going to be the next one I'm going to try to like complete in its entirety because I really like Dystopia. I think I've heard. I don't remember if Washington is next, but I think Kick the Chair was on it. We just did the title track last week, but I've heard a few off of it, and they're all really solid songs. Let me actually look since I have Dystopia pulled up. So I've done, I believe Dystopia, I think I've done Fatal Illusion, Conquer or Die, I'm pretty sure I've done, May Hate You. So I've done quite a few off of Dystopia, and they're actually really good songs, so I'm probably going to try and focus on that one next. Finishing up that one so that I can listen to the album in its entirety, that'd be great. But for now, we're doing Blood of Heroes and then Elysian Fields. Sorry for the long intro. But yeah, let's go ahead and jump right into it. Now, Blood of Heroes apparently is about the band. Despite all the bad things that have happened to the band and in the band, they said that they're still here. They're still going to keep on going. And so, lyrically, it sounds like it's a pretty positive song. But let's go ahead and check it out. Ooh, I like the drums. I can't remember what those are called. The big old drums that they play in the parades. Ooh. This album, I'm definitely getting a shirt for. Really cool riffs right here. Kind of simple, but I really like it. Definitely more of a rock album. Some pretty cool riffs in here. Chorus is definitely really nice. I like the harmonizing that I hear. This one's definitely more of a simplistic one. Of course, that's really Euthanasia for you. But I really enjoy it. Dave's voice sounds really good, and I can really hear the bass pretty clearly. I really don't see the point of this being remastered either because the original mix was good enough. It didn't need a remaster in my opinion. Ooh, okay. Kind of a different solo. Ooh. Alright, getting a little bit of a wah effect. Alright, I like it. I don't know if this is Dave. I've never really heard him play a wah pedal. Ooh, I like the... went to a more Doom sound there for a second. Heroes, I wonder what that phaser effect is on the vocals. It's kind of weird. I like it though. I love that ride cymbal. Ride cymbals in metal is something I always love. This chorus is super catchy too. Okay, going to a different. That was a pretty good song. I hesitate to call it the best off of Euthanasia. I've definitely heard some others that blew me away. So just for example, I Thought I Knew It All. That's definitely my favorite off of the album, at least so far. There's a few songs I haven't heard, like Elysium Fields, and there's a couple others. But I wouldn't say that this song is my favorite, but it's definitely a pretty good one. So you guys may have noticed that I was trying to talk more during the particular song. That's because I realized that sometimes I don't talk enough. And in order for this to stay fair use, you have to hear my commentary over the song. So that's something I will definitely be trying to do in the future, is put more of my voice over it, because it's not intended to be, as Deuce would put it, a broadcast, right? Because this isn't supposed to be you guys listening to the actual song. You're supposed to hear my thoughts, my opinions, my commentary over the song. So that's what you guys will be seeing more of, even if it's just thoughts that I have to say out loud that I'm thinking in my head I'll be doing, because ultimately this is designed to be fair use. It's not designed to be a playthrough of the song, essentially. So that's just something you'll see in the future, something I'm already trying to work on. But yeah, I thought it was a pretty good song. I would rate it, I'd rate it about a 4. It didn't blow me away, but it was certainly really good. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and check out Elysian Fields. One of the things I'm also trying to sort of incorporate more of is less of a time afterwards talking about a song and doing it sort of as the song goes by, so that like you guys don't hear me talking about a song for like 5 minutes afterwards. I like to just talk about stuff as it's happening. Anyways, let's check out Elysian Fields. Now this is actually a pretty, I don't know how much of it I'm going to get into lyrically. We'll talk about it at first. So the song is about God and man, heaven and earth, life and death. Okay. The lyrics are about how it is in man's nature to fight. In the song, Mustaine says mankind rejected Jesus Christ and therefore does not want to be saved. The song is apparently about how people will fight no matter if it's here, no matter if it's in the afterlife, and people will still try and conquer even if it's in the afterlife. They'll try and conquer hell, they'll try and conquer heaven. That's essentially what this song is about. I'm gonna not really say too much on the lyric side, because there's people of all different beliefs that are on this channel, and I prefer not to inject my own, even though you guys know my own, it's well documented. I just prefer not to talk about it, because that kind of stuff does nothing but divide people, so I am not going to talk about that very much. Anyways, let's check out the song. Ooh, that was heavy. Okay. So that bass definitely hit really hard, or at least the beat dropped really hard. And this song is definitely more energetic than the previous one. Ooh, that bass sounds really nice. Got some really nice riffs going here too. I honestly don't see why this album was remastered, because the original mix was really good. Oh, I love that ride cymbal. I like the sort of gang vocals that are happening as well. I think that's Dave. No, that could actually be the other band members. We like how it kind of slows it down here to give you a little bit of a break. And builds, I'm assuming, yep. I don't know. Got some really cool, got some really cool blues riffs in here, too. Ooh, that's nice. This song's got a lot of groove to it. Of course, that's Euthanasia for you. I kind of want to learn some of Euthanasia's songs. They seem like it'd be fun to learn on guitar. Ooh, I like that. That bass cuts through the mix super well. I really enjoy that. The right cymbal is probably my favorite cymbal, and I really like how prominent it is on this song. Distortion sounds really nice on it too, this album. Ooh, okay, where are we going from here? Is that a harmonica solo? What? That's awesome. I did not expect that. The lead play sounds really good too. Oh, there's that harmonica again. I don't think it was that time. I like how they go to halftime on that. It sounds really cool. And that lead, ooh, that sounds nice. There's so much layering on this song, I love it. Ooh, that, tasty. Okay, that was good. In terms of quality, I would put that one at the top of the album. That was amazing. I loved how they brought everything together at the end right there, and there was tons of overlapping and layering. I really, really enjoyed that. I really like it when songs layer in general. They start with one instrument, and they add another, and then they add another. But this one, it just seemed like everything was coming to a head, like at the end of the song, and it sounded absolutely amazing. There was some really cool harmonizing during this song that I really enjoyed as well with the vocals. And I believe that was a harmonica, and it sounded really cool. There's definitely a lot of blues in this song, which definitely sounded really cool. I mean, it had like this really groovy tone to it, which I really enjoyed. So, yeah, that would say that one's going to be tough to beat. Hopefully, Post-American World. I'm pretty sure this one's going to be way heavier. But in terms of just melody and catchiness overall, it has to be Elysian Fields for this week's video. Anyways, without further ado, let's check out Post-American World. This is actually the video. Hopefully I'm not making a mistake by checking out the video instead of the song, and I will give it a pause here because if this gets blocked, I'll have to cut out this section. So, thank you guys so much for watching in the event that I have to cut this out. So let's go. Videos are normally pretty, they're hit or miss for me. It's about half and half whether they get blocked or they don't. Megadeth is normally pretty good. Okay. Ooh. Now, apparently, this is Symphony of Destruction Part 2. One of my favorite Megadeth songs of all time. Oh, yeah, I hear it. Ooh. Segregating ourselves by class and size. I hear the Symphony of Destruction. Oh, yeah. I see what... This is nice. I like this. This planet's become One big spinning disaster. Reminds me a lot of Symphony, actually. If you don't like where we're going, I feel like I've heard this one. I may have already checked out this video, or I may have heard it before. What will we look like in the post-American world? Why cower to all those who oppose the American world? I may have heard this one before the channel started. That chorus, I remember. So that was pretty nice. Okay. Dave's voice actually sounds really good. The snarling vocals sound really good for this type of thing. Yeah, that's true. I don't remember much of the rest of the song, but I'm pretty sure I've heard this chorus before. Okay. Now I looked for this song in my videos, so unless it was one of the ones where I did a surprise extra song, it's not appearing on my videos. And I think I would have remembered this one. This is a really nice one. I'm thinking this is the Dave solo. Ooh, all right. I like the harmonizing. Oh, okay. Guitar solos are really nice, and I really like the riff in the background. That's nice, too. Drums on this album are spectacular. I like this sort of digital clock sort of overlay over the video. Certain sections that like that. I feel like I've heard this song. Ooh, okay, nice riff. Fan out. I like how that hourglass showed like metal shards in it. It looked like they were taking a magnet on the bottom so that they would all like stack up like that. That was a pretty cool effect. Let's let the rest of the video play out. I am hoping I haven't already listened to this song on the channel, because I'm going to feel really stupid if I did. Now, I did search in my videos. I did search Post-American World, and nothing came up. The only thing that came up was a video I'd done called Reactions Are Postponed. That was like a while back, and that was not Post-American World. But I feel like I strongly feel like I've heard this one before, but I only remember certain pieces of it. So if I have heard this one, it was either before I started my channel, because I did listen to like one or two Dystopia songs off of Dystopia before I started my channel, but I don't remember which ones they were. It honestly could have been this one, because I do remember watching a music video. So that could be an option, or it could be because I've done some surprise Megadeth songs. I've done like unplanned reactions where I've just let the video do an autoplay to the next song because it's one I hadn't heard before. And I would just leave that as a surprise because it So unless it was something like that, those are really the only two options. Because that chorus I remembered, the ending too I did remember to an extent, and so I'm just wondering how I remember this song when I clearly haven't. It's not appearing on my videos. So that's just one of the two things that could have happened. It was one or the other. Either it was just a surprise song on a video, or it was one I had heard before. Either way, it was a really good song. I could definitely see the Symphony of Destruction inspirations. I could definitely see how this is a part two to that song. The verse riff sounded a lot like it. In my head, I was sort of like putting the Symphony of Destruction riff over it, and yeah, it definitely would have fit this song. Really good song. I really like the melody in this song. The chorus was really, really nice. I like the harmonizing in the guitar solos. I like both guitar solos. They were pretty cool. I didn't really tell which one was Dave because I wasn't paying attention to what guitar he was playing when it was showed fa his face. And there was both a red and I think a black guitar, so I'm not really sure which one was his during the solo. I'm pretty sure it wasn't the one with the wah pedal, or is it the previous song? I can't remember. I got so distracted by like thinking I've heard this song before that I can't remember if that wah was in this one or the other one. Either way, I'm pretty sure Kiko was one of them and Dave Mustaine was the other one. Both solos were pretty awesome. Guys, that is going to be all for this video, and I have to remind you guys, please, 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 please recommend some videos in the comment section down below. Even if it's some I may have gone already over already, I need you guys to start putting stuff in the comments because I'm only getting like two or three people like recommending stuff, and if it's not for that, then I'm gonna have to start looking for it on my own, and I want it to be viewer requested. Of course, it could be also like I've already done the majority of what people want, and so there's really only the deep cuts left. But either way, please keep recommending stuff if possible. Because I definitely want to keep doing this series as long as possible. So, without further ado, we will see you guys later.